We want to welcome each and every one of you to this program this morning. A special welcome to our visitors, grandparents, family, and friends who are here with us today as our children bring us this Christmas story. Also, we'd like to also have the children, when they get done with this Christmas program, that they could go to their room, and there'll be a sack of treats there for them. And also, there'll be a sack of treats for each teacher, each helper, and each pianist and each song leader there also. And that would be from grades kindergarten 3 and 4 and through 11th and 12th grade. Shall we open with prayer? Father in heaven, we thank you that long ago in history that you have promised to send a Savior. We thank you today for the gift of your Son, Jesus, who was born into this world. And Father, we just ask that you'll be with each one of these children as they bring this Christmas message to us this morning. We ask that you'll be with each teacher who has taught them throughout this past year, that their hearts may be open to hear and to receive this word. And Father, we just thank you that the teachers and the helpers and the song leaders and the pianists, all them and all those on the Christmas committee, have been able to teach this word to these children. And as they tell us the Christmas story this morning, all this we ask for your name's sake, for Jesus' sake, amen.
And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel.
Therefore, as through one man's offense, judgment came to all men, resulting in condemnation, even so through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification of life. For as by one man's disobedience, many were made sinners, so also by one man's obedience, many will be made righteous.
Thank you. Now the Lord had said to Abram, "Get out of your country, from your family, and from your father's house, to a land that I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name great, and you shall be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and I will curse him who curses you. And in you all the families of the earth shall be blessed."
Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles in Christ Jesus, that we might receive the promise of the Spirit through faith.
Yeah. Therefore, the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take you, Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us.
Oh, Jesus, finished. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there will be no end, upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice from that time forward, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
And leaving Nazareth, he came and dwelt in Capernaum, which is by the sea, in the regions of Zebulun and Naphtali, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah, the prophet, saying, In the land of Zebulun and in the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea, beyond the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people who sat in darkness have seen a great light, and upon those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned.
Oh, Bethlehem Ephrathah, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be ruler of Israel, whose goings forth are from of old, from everlasting.
Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Stars in the sky. rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem. Behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding on a donkey, a colt, the foal of a donkey. I will cut off the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The battle bow shall be cut off. He shall speak peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea and from the river to the ends of the earth.
Jesus answered them, "Do you now believe? Indeed, the hour is coming, yes, has now come, that you will be scattered, each to his own, and will leave me alone. And yet I am not alone, because the Father is with me. These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you may have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world."
Sleeping on the hay,
sleeping on the hay,
Jesus. together. Our Father in heaven, we rejoice. Our hearts overflow with a good theme as we contemplate your goodness shown to us in providing a Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord. We thank you for this season. Mystery of godliness, that God was manifest in the flesh for us and for our salvation. We also give you thanksgiving that your covenant mercies are from one generation to the next generation. So we rejoice to hear the voices of our young adults read from Scripture the prophecies and also the fulfillment of the prophecies of Jesus Christ, and also to hear the voices of young children sing forth your praises. We humbly ask that you would incline their hearts to exercise faith in Jesus Christ and follow him all the days of their life. We thank you too, Father, for the many volunteers of this congregation who have given so tirelessly to produce this program of praise and thanksgiving to you. We ask that you would hear our prayers and look upon us in your grace and in your mercy, for Jesus' sake. Amen.